Centennial Challenges is a great platform to ideate and come up with new innovative technologies, and we have demonstrated it through various challenges in the past, and including Break the Ice Challenge, where we're actually testing a robot at the TRL-7 in the lunar environmental conditions, which is a perfect example of how we run Centennial Challenges and how we can use excellent facilities across Marshall Space Flight Center.
Break the Ice gave us a roadmap during a very young stage of our company to really put deadlines, to work towards some goals, and to like flow well as a team and with our timelines.
So what this has allowed us to do is iterate very rapidly and kind of remove our fear of failure, which has been super advantageous for us, being able to test hardware really quickly and make the best quality products. Centennial Challenges has been really huge for Starpath. Starting out as a very small company, these challenges set forth by the Centennial program, particularly for lunar mobility, were really, really core to shaping the design philosophy behind the rover.
The main goal is to really ground how we move forward from this test to our next future designs. Rover 9 and 10 never went into a thermal vacuum chamber, so this is our first time actually testing the full system at scale, and this will let us analyze and ground our future rover models.
The first phase of the test is really important for us to understand how heat flows through our rover. So we've done some really, really advanced thermal modeling and made some really educated guesses about how heat is going to go from one component to another and then eventually get rejected out to the ambient environment. But doing this test allows us to actually say, hey, was our guess right? Was it wrong? How much is it off by? And we'll use those correlation factors in the design of our next rover. And then the driving part, where we come off the stand and move around and mine concrete, that's more of a functional test. It's confirmed that the rover can traverse those slopes, it can go over those rocks, it has enough traction on the sand, and it can mine that concrete.